Hey guys, welcome to another video for the Poco X3 Pro. Now, before we start this video, there are a couple of things that I need to let you know. I am traveling right now. I'm in Rajasthan, India. That's my native place. I'm about 1,000 kilometers away from my city, that is Mumbai. So if you see a little bit of echo, or if you see that the brightness is here or the focus is there, kindly adjust, because I'm shooting these videos in very, very bad conditions. We have around 35 to 40 degrees outside. It is very difficult to get perfect benchmarks. The phones are struggling for signal, and most of the times they are warm. You know, these coming 8 to 10 days will be more or less accurate, but if you see something is off, feel free to mention that in the comment section. I will be back in Mumbai on the 17th, and from there the streams and all the daily uploads, 2 uploads a day, should get back to completely normal. But that's not what we are here about today. We are talking about the official MIUI 12.5.3 for the Poco X3 Pro. Trust me when I say that I downloaded it on the go on data, and I used all tools I could to make a backup, and then I flashed it, and I've been using it since then. I've been using it since almost a couple of days now, and I do have my share of things to share in this particular review. But before we get into all of that, if you haven't already, please subscribe and hit the notification bell icon so that you get notified every time I upload a video. In the description of each video, you will find a link to our Telegram community where you can join us and support the channel. Last but not the least, if you think the hard work is worth the effort, please click on the join button and support the channel. Now, without further ado, hello awesome people, welcome to Phone Ops. My name is Kailash. Let's get going. Alright, so official MIUI 12.5 for the Poco X3 Pro in India. It is still based on Android 11, but hey, 12.5 has been a major update. A lot of people were expecting it, and unfortunately, the story is the same with Xiaomi, that in different regions, the same phone is getting sort of a different software experience. I started saying this in the 12.0.6 update for the RAW file, that is K20 Pro, and I am very, very sad to report that it is continuing. But let's talk about the complete review nonetheless. So moving on, let's quickly go to settings over here, right? Settings, and if we go to about phone, you will see that it says it is MIUI 12.5.3 global stable. That's what they're calling it, stable. Android version is Android 11. June security patch, very, very, you know, close to being the official security patch for the available month, because we recently got the July security patch from Google. So good job there, Xiaomi. If you go to all specifications, you have the MIUI version, the kernel, and all the other information. So nothing major to check there and worry about. But I will tell you this. So first thing that I would like to share is that the whole UI sluggishness is still there, but it's better. I've seen that the apps are much more smoother. The scrolling is much more smoother. The, you know, refresh rate, dynamic refresh rate is much better compared to what it was earlier, right? But what do we get if, you know, I'm not going to reboot the device and tell you, but you do get a very, very subtle and annoying boot sound. That is the first thing that you get with MIUI 12.5, because the moment you boot, you would notice that. So you can actually go ahead and disable that. So if you actually go to sound and you go to additional settings, you have this boot audio, which you can definitely go ahead and disable. I had kept it enabled, but you can go ahead and disable it. Right now, moving on, in the ringtone UI, notifications and alarm options, if you actually go ahead and go to sound and vibration, right, and if you go to notifications, okay, now ideally this would be the case, because most of you will have your internet connected or active. But I'll tell you what happens if you actually go ahead and disable your internet connect completely. So if you don't have your internet connected, you will get a tiled user interface like this in alarm, in notifications, in ringtones. But if you have your internet or mobile data enabled, you will be taken to their app store. Typical Xiaomi stuff there. Now moving on, if we talk about the control center, you can now swipe left to get notifications and again back to the control center. If you scroll further down, you will notice it shows you even more tiles for notifications and stuff. And as I said in my earlier videos as well, the brightness bar stays at the bottom. It doesn't go all the way at the bottom, so it doesn't look buggy. In the mobile data section, you still don't have the data usage. And if you try to change the brightness, it disappears. Everything everything in the background gets disappeared, like all the other tiles and stuff. So that's a pretty neat touch by Xiaomi. So good job there, right? Now moving on, talking about the UI elements of MIUI 12.5, you have a new volume slider. You have three dots at the top which you can use to expand and decide which particular sound or audio you want to increase or decrease. And if you select D&D over here, you will get a toast notification. Now, apart from this, moving on, if you go to apps, right, settings and then apps, you do have a couple of new options. One of them is manage home screen shortcuts, and then you have uninstalled system apps. So in manage home screen shortcuts, basically what happens is nothing major over here. All the stringent apps that always stay on your home screen, if you disable this, you will not see that anymore on the home screen. So that is a neat feature. Uninstall system apps, it was working on the 12.5 global stable for the K20 Pro, but for some reason it is broken on MIUI 12.5.3 for the Poco X3 Pro, and I'm not able to go ahead and uninstall any system applications at all. So that's pretty sad from Xiaomi's end, because they did promise that they will be doing this and it was a highlight feature in their keynote, but unfortunately that option is not there. Now, these were the things which are added. These are the new features that you get with MIUI 12.5. So now we are going to focus the things which are not included. These could include things which are there in MIUI China stable but not included in the global stable or the Indian stable version for that matter. So first things first, the biggest problem that we have with MI devices or Xiaomi devices in India, not MI devices, is the dreaded Poco launcher. Now the reason I say this is because the animations are still not even half baked. It's broken. The stutter is there. So if you look at the Google feed, sometimes it stutters, sometimes it doesn't. The app drawer is pretty smooth. Now, I will not say that I've not experienced an improvement when it comes to comparing this with MIUI 12. It is definitely smoother. It is definitely, you know, more fluent when it comes to the dynamic refresh rate and stuff. But the Poco launcher still doesn't get a ton of options. Even if you go to the multitasking menu, you will not see an option for floating applications, which is a bummer, because floating apps is something which Xiaomi had made a big deal about when they had introduced MIUI 12. So such a big feature that they talked about is not available. Apart from floating window not being there, there are other things that we can talk about. We can talk about the file manager, the gallery, and the camera application. Now, you would think that I'm talking about these three applications because they have some updates or changes. Sorry, no changes, no updates at all. Even the power menu, if you have a look at it, we still have the old power menu. I don't understand. Something as simple as a power menu, you cannot give us the new one. I really don't see the point. Even the privacy controls are not like MIUI 12.5 China. They are still the same old MIUI 12 privacy controls. So what really is a bummer is MIUI 13 is about to be announced, and Indian devices, global devices, still don't have a lot of proper MIUI 12.5 features. The experience on the Poco X3 Pro is still laggy. If you're expecting that after getting the MIUI 12.5.3 update in India, magically all the lag will disappear, trust me, it's not gonna happen. Now we come to the benchmark numbers. Now this is where I have a slight problem, because as I said, I'm in a different part of the country. The temperatures here are 35 to 40 degrees during the day, which means that the phone is running warm most of the time. So I did run Geekbench, I did run the CPU throttle test, but I strongly believe that the results might not be accurate. But even in that case, I will tell you, I tried BGMI, the performance has been fine. I did not try 90 FPS, I tried the standard approved 60 FPS, which has been working fine for me. Another thing is, if you actually go to settings, so I'm not going to show you the benchmark numbers, as I said, because they are not accurate, but just for the kicks, if you want to have a look, I'll show you the screenshot of how bad it was. And mind you, I ran these benchmarks after keeping the phone off for 15 minutes. So it should have cooled down considerably. This is how the benchmark looks, even after enabling Game Turbo for the CPU throttle test. And for that matter, even if you go to Geekbench over here, there's something definitely wrong with the multi-core score. There you go. 740 and 1599 over here, it was 2452. So I understand that I'm in a warmer climate. Now this also gives us a learning that if you are in a city where the temperatures are generally high, the ambient temperatures, you might have an issue with benchmark numbers and your phone might be running a little warm as well. So all in all, talking about the 12.5.3 update, I was just saying that I have played BGMI, I did play some other games like Call of Duty, and as for the gaming experience has been fine, but as I said, this update gives you slightly better performance, but the laggy UI and the missing features are still there. So if you're on 12.0.4 or 12.0.5, you're still getting decent performance like you were getting when the phone was brand new. And mind you, this device is just 3 to 4 months old. You can stay on that. There is nothing brand new that you would experience over here which will change your feeling and give you a wow factor. Now that is my take on the MIUI 12.5.3 update for the Poco X3 Pro. Let me know in the comment section if you've updated or not. Until the next one, this is Kailash signing off at PhoneOps. Keep smiling. Take care. Goodbye.